Center of Excellence, the United States Army School, and the 316 Cavalry Brigade are proud to host Operation Thunderstrike, a live fire exercise demonstration to kick off the Fort Worth Sullivan Cup competition. During the remainder of Armor Week, you'll have the opportunity to watch the most lethal armored cruise in the Army compete for the prestigious 2024 Sullivan Cup. Join us at Operation Thunderstrike, our 18 crews from the active Army, Army National Guard, Canada, Germany, the Netherlands, and Poland. Please stand and be recognized. These armored crewmen stand before you today, representing the 1st Armored Division, the 1st Cavalry Division, the 1st Infantry Division, the 3rd Infantry Division, the 4th Infantry Division, the 11th Armored Cavalry Regiment, the 278th Armored Cavalry Regiment, the Royal Canadian Armored Corps School, the 1st Panzer Division, the 18th Mechanized Division, and the 43rd Mechanized Brigade. Cavalry soldiers on large and strong horses were used to break enemy formations and cause chaos on the battlefield. Small, light, fast horses were used to scout, patrol, and pursue enemies, taking advantage of superior agility and maneuver. Cavalry scouts retrieve spot signs of the enemy and track their movements while staying hidden, relaying intelligence to their commanders. They also became specialized marksmen who could shoot very accurately over long distances. During the Revolutionary War, there were three types of mounted commands. These included the heavy cavalry, overseers, used primarily for shock effect, light cavalry, hosers, mainly used for reconnaissance, training, and liaison missions. Finally, the dragoons, trained to fight on horseback.
Contact with an enemy reconnaissance force, conduct an easy defensive against the enemy advance guard, and finally conduct a mass
squad leader, who is responsible for planning and execution of the squad's mission. Next in seniority is a sergeant team leader, who serves as the assistant patrol leader. The squad is also assigned a radio telephone operator, or RTO, equipped with the ANPRC-119 dismounted radio kit. This radio is used not only to pass intelligence to the commander, but also call for indirect fire and communicate with other units. The final members of the squad are three cavalry scouts, responsible for security and observation. These dismounted scouts are all armed with the M4 carbine rifle. This fully modular weapon has an integrated receiver rail that can mount the N68 Close Combat Optic or the Advanced Combat Optical Gun Sight. The M4 carbine can deliver both semi-automatic and fully automatic fire on the battlefield. The scouts will now execute a screen and observe named Area of Interest 1, or NAI-1, which is south of Baseline Strike and along Avenue Approach 1, while the 316 Brigade prepares their defensive positions. Indirect fire to disrupt and defeat the threat.